What inspired you to go into meteorology and atmospheric science?
Well, interestingly, I had a lot of strange childhood encounters with weather, such as my house starting on fire from lightning and a tornado passing right by my house, but I didn't really think of meteorology as a field to pursue until I was an undergrad majoring in physics, and I happened to see a poster for a summer institute on atmospheric science, and they wanted physics majors to apply. So I applied and I went, and I found out that was just a great application of physics, really, and totally interesting. So I decided that that's what I would pursue for graduate school.
So now that you're here at Penn State, what is your main area of research?
So I study severe storms, and I study them really from the time that they're born, which we call convective initiation, until the time that they make a tornado, and until the tornado dies eventually. And anywhere in there is kind of fair game for me to study. And I do that with both observations and numerical models. Both are really useful for looking at the problem.
So given that you study severe weather, your research obviously then has a huge impact on society.
Yeah, I think anyone who studies severe weather does it with the hope that eventually the research that you do will go toward improving warnings so that people can take better cover or just not be warned if there isn't actually going to be something bad happening. So improvements in all of that, I think, is really the eventual societal goal that you hope your research can contribute to. I find doing research and teaching to both be kind of equally interesting and fascinating, and we have a great program at Penn State that allows me to do both, and so I love being here, and I love doing my job.